In this video, I'm going to share with you a step-by-step tutorial on how to design your very own ebook in Canva. An ebook is a great lead magnet because it helps you educate your prospects on a topic in a more detailed way. The length of your ebook entirely depends on your goals. For some, this can be as short as 15 pages, but for others, it can be as lengthy as 50 pages or more. You must remember though that it's not about the number of pages, but the amount of value you provide. Woo! Welcome to Lou Designs. I'm Lou and I'm a self-taught graphic designer. In this channel, I share easy to follow Canva and graphic design tips for non-designers who want to design their own graphics but ends up spending hours in Canva, which leads to feeling overwhelmed and ends up not designing anything at all. If that's you, be sure to subscribe and tap the bell icon so you'll be notified when I upload a new video. Open Canva and search for ebook in the search bar. Hit enter. And as you can see, there will be a lot of beautiful ebook templates available here to choose from. Select the template that gives you that oomph factor. You know, the template that makes you feel excited to customize or design it. You can choose a template that has several pages already. So when you hover your mouse to that template, you'll find out how many pages it includes here. And then there will be a carousel animation to see a preview of how the pages look like. So once you find the template that appeals to you the most, click that. I kinda like this one. It has 14 pages already and I love the minimal but elegant vibes of this template. If you want more layout options, you can choose further here on the side menu. Since we already have 14 pages and different types of layouts, I think this works fine. Now it's time to customize your ebook. Add your text content, and I suggest having it in a word processing app or a Google document so that it would be easier for you to decide in Canva. You can simply copy the content, the text content here, and paste it in your ebook. Okay, so let's copy my title here. Paste it here. Okay, so I think I'd have to delete this one. Okay, so I think I'm satisfied with the size. And then I will add the subtitle here, paste it here. Let's adjust the size of this box. What I want to do is make sure that this is in the middle of the box so that it would look good. So a trick that I like is selecting these two elements, the text and the box, click position and select middle. This will align my text to the box, to the middle portion of the box. And if it's not centered, I could select that again, select position, and choose center. Let's change these two designs. Let's move this box here and adjust this image, make this bigger. It would be a balanced design. We can also select all of this and adjust this to the middle. So as you can see, it has a more balanced look. Let's leave this stock photo for now. I don't have an about me section, so I think I'll just use this introduction. Change this photo to your personal photo. Just go to uploads, upload your personal photo here. Use this one. And simply drag that over here, adjust, and there you go. So let me just copy all of the text from the Google document that I already created and paste this here. I will fast forward this so that you will not be bored. It's also nice to add a quotes page to your ebook, just like this one. So the final page will be a great opportunity for you to promote your course or your coaching program or whatever it is that you want to promote. I am not really sure with this layout, so let's find another. When you click a template here, this will give you a bigger preview of what's inside. I think I like this one. So I'll add a page and then this one, delete this, change the text. I want to make this bigger, adjust it here. You can also add your social media links here, so just go to elements and search for social media icon, so Instagram for example, and then let's add this one, let's add Pinterest. Now let's add the stock photos, so just go to photos, you can search for a specific type of photo here in the search bar, or you can find photos that you think would fit your design in the trending tab. Or let me try minimalist. So I think I kind of love this one, so let's try this. Yes, and I love that. And my tip to find cohesive stock photos is to click this three dot icon, click this link, view more by the name of the creator. So this one is from Floral Deco, and as you can see, you can find all the photos from that specific creator. So this is such a great time saver in Canva. So let's use this. If you want, you can also add decorative elements to your workbook. So search for elements, you can search from the search bar, or you can find them here under graphics tab, and then find one that you think would look great with this by dragging that here. For me, I'm okay with the existing layout. I don't want to add decorative elements to my ebook. So now try to add a video. Since an ebook can be used digitally, you can also add a YouTube video or a video from the videos tab. So click this videos icon and you can drag this here. You can also add videos directly from YouTube. Just click more, this icon here, and search for YouTube. You can search the video that you want to include in your ebook here. Let's search for anything, click that. Now you can include that in your design. You can also change these colors to your brand colors and fonts. And the easiest way to do that is using a brand kit. Brand kit is only available, I think, for Canva Pro users. On your Canva homepage, click this brand kit icon and you can add a brand kit and add your logo, your brand colors, and your brand fonts. So if you want to change your fonts to your brand fonts easily, just click fonts, change this to your brand kit. You can see that here are the fonts that I use, so I can easily apply that to my design. You can also change the colors to my brand colors here. As easy as that. If you don't have a brand kit because you're using a free version of Canva, you can just select one color, this one for example, and then copy this style to all of the other pages of your workbook easily by using the copy style tool. Click the color or style that you want to copy and click this copy style icon and apply that to other pages. As easy as that. When you're happy with your ebook design, it's now time to add clickable links. To do that, double click the text box and highlight the part of the text that you want to add a link, or you can simply click that object. Click this link icon over here, copy the URL of your link, paste that here, and hit enter from your keyboard. It automatically adds underline to your text. So if you want to remove the underline, simply click the text box and deselect underline icon here. To link to another page within the design, like the table of contents, for example, let's edit our table of contents first. Let's paste this evenly by selecting all of this text, select position, and click vertically. So they will be spaced out evenly vertically. I suggest changing the page titles so you can easily link them from the table of contents. Let's add the links by clicking the text box, click the link icon, and then find the page under the pages in this document tab. Click that and do that to the rest. And then you can deselect underline all at once by selecting all of this, drag your mouse, and deselect the underline icon. Now this will redirect us to another page inside this document. You can also add the link to your social media pages here. So click the icon, copy the link to your profile, this one's for Instagram, and again select the link icon here, paste your Instagram link, hit enter, and same goes to Pinterest. Copy your profile link, click the Pinterest social icon, click link, paste your link, hit enter, and there you go. Now that you're finished designing your ebook and you've added all the links, it's now time to publish and share your ebook. Be sure to rename your ebook before downloading it. Click this button, share, select download. You have two options here, PDF standard and PDF print. PDF standard has a lower resolution compared to PDF print, meaning it won't take up much space on your hard drive, making it perfect for digital uses such as an ebook. But if you want to give your ebook reader or ebook user an option to print this, you can also save another copy, which is a PDF print file. So let's choose PDF standard and then select all pages and click download. And now let's test our ebook. Let's see if the links are working. Let's click this website link. And it's working. We are redirected to my website. And let's check our table of contents. Let's click this. Yes, it's working. Finally, let's check our social media icons. Again, it is working. And that's how you design your very own professional looking ebook in Canva. If you find this helpful, please share this with your friends. Comment below if you have any questions or suggestions. Don't forget to subscribe and tap the bell icon so you'll be notified when I upload a new video. I hope you got a lot of aha moments in this tutorial. See you on the next one. Bye!